Hey and welcome back to another Darkfall tutorial. Today we're going to be creating a sci-fi sky effect, as you can see in the example here. So the first thing we need to make sure that we're in Cycles Render, and also the resolution is the same as the movie clip that you're using. We also want to make sure the resolution slider is at 100%. And we can go ahead and change this from the 3D view to the node editor. Let's change this to the scene tab. And as always, we need to check use nodes and backdrop. Now we don't need the render layer here, so let's press X, delete that, Shift A, go to input and add in a movie clip. If you want to use the same movie clip that I'm using, I'll throw a link in the description as well. Connect that up and then go ahead and open up the movie clip. So now we need to see the movie clip, so Shift A, go to output, then add a viewer node. If you have the node wrangler add-on enabled, you can press Ctrl Shift and left click. If not, just connect this up to the viewer now. We also want to zoom out, so just zoom out a little bit so we can see what we're doing. And press N to get rid of the sidebar. So now we want to use another movie clip, so what we can do is if we select this movie clip, Shift D, duplicate that. And now we want to change this movie clip, so if we select this icon here, and again I'll throw a link in the description if you want to use this one too. So Shift A, go to Color, then Mix, drop this one here, connect this up to the viewer node, and we also want to connect this one to the mix as well. Now depending on what blend mode we choose, it will have a different look. I'm going to choose Add for now. So now we want to move things around and change things a little bit, so Shift A, let's go to Distort, Transform, just drop this here after the movie clip. I just want to move this over because if we play through the movie clip here, we can see the guy walks out into the sand and then he kind of looks up into the sky. And it'd be good if we can sort of match where he's looking to where this effect is playing. So if we move this over on the X, kind of like that. Then on the Y, we also want to increase this a little bit, make it bigger. Yeah, that should be good. Now another thing we can do is we want to change these colors and make it brighter as well. So Shift A, let's first go to Converter, RGB to black and white. Just drop this here. And Shift A, Color RGB Curves. I just want to increase the brightness of this. Now another thing you might notice is these sort of lines here. It looks very detailed, so Shift A, go to Filter, then Blur, drop this in here. I'm going to blur this, say maybe 7, 6 or 7, maybe a bit more. So now it looks a little bit better as well, it looks more smoother and more like clouds. Okay, so the next thing we can do is add some color to this. Let's Shift A. Now you can add color in different ways. You could add a mix node, or you could go to Converter, Color Ramp. You can do this any way you want, but I'm going to use the Color Balance. It's a very easy node to use. For the shadows, I just want to drag this all the way down to the orange. Bring this into the reds. This into the yellows. Brighten this up a bit. Okay, it's not looking too bad. We do need to change the background because that blue is just it's not working with it. So what we need to do is just change the background blue. What we can do is add a mask. So let's change this from the node editor to the movie clip editor. Select this icon here and choose the video that we want to mask, which is this one. Then it's pretty simple. We'll just change this from tracking to masking. Add a new mask. Rename this. We're fairly lucky that the guy doesn't go over the skyline, he stays below the skyline. If he did, what you'd have to do is just create another mask, just rotoscoping him out. Control left click, we can add these mask points. I'm going to make a very rough mask here. Alt C to close a mask. So now we can just zoom in and just refine this a little bit better. For this skyline, we don't have to be too accurate. And what we can do is add a blur node and it will sort of feather the horizon. to make it look a lot better. If you had a more complex skyline, you might have to add more points and just, you know, mask around every building or whatever you're trying to mask out. But that should work for us. Change this back over to the node editor. And now what we can do, if we shift A, go to color, mix, drop this on here, shift A, input, mask, then we want to choose the mask that we just created, and then plug this into the factor. Now we want to change this color to, say, an orange color, and again, play around with the blend mode to find something that works for you. I think soft light should be good for this. Yeah, it looks a lot better. And again, see, it might be hard to notice, but this line here is very sharp. What we can do is shift A, go to filter, blur, say 13. It's not very noticeable unless you press N and zoom in. So this is with the blur, and then this is without the blur. So another thing we can do is maybe add a planet or a moon in the background. Shift A, input, image. So the image that I'm going to use, I downloaded off Pexels. I'll throw a link in the description to that one too. So now what we can do is shift A, color mix again. And let's drop this image into this one here. So let's select this icon here to enable the alpha. We can see it'll show the background. Shift A, go to distort, then transform, drop this here. We just want to scale this down quite a bit. And then let's bring it over here. So when you're happy with the positioning, what we need to do is kind of make it transparent to sell the effect that it's off in the distance. So a very easy way to do that is just by dropping the factor. And it kind of looks okay, but what I want to do is create a gradient so it's sort of more transparent on this side and less transparent over here. So that's very simple to do. If we change this from the scene tab to the material tab, and we also want to change this to the world tab, and then check new, and then check use nodes. So it's a few steps, but once you've done that, you can create a new texture, which you can kind of see it here. We press G, and this will bring this over, and then left click. Let's just name this texture. It's going to be called gradient. In fact, we're going to create another gradient, so let's call this planet gradient. So just like the other nodes, we have an output, we have something that's plugged into it. We don't need this, so press X. Shift A, go to textures. Now, for a while I was looking for a gradient and I just completely missed the word blend. I didn't even realize what it was, but yeah, blend is gradient. So choose blend, plug this in. So this is going to be our first gradient. What you can do is, well, you can change it to have a radial or spherical, but for this example we want to change this quadratic. You can choose any one of these that you want, something that fits your scene, but I'm going to use quadratic for now. It looks pretty good. I also want to create another gradient for the kind of atmosphere, so let's create another texture while we're here. Just call it gradient. We also want to check use nodes. Press G, bring these over. Delete this one. Shift A. Textures blend. And now for this one, I want to change it to vertical, so it looks like this. And I also want to change this one to easing. And then we want to change these colors to something that will match our scene. So for this black, I want to choose orange color. And then for this white, maybe a gold color. It's not too bad. Okay, so let's change this back now to the scene tab. So let's fix this moon's transparency. So shift A, go to input, texture, Let's drop this up here. Now we need to select the texture material. So this is the planet gradient. And we plug not the value, but the color into the factor. It's kind of working already. What we need to do now is adjust the gradient to be more to the left-hand side so we get more of this planet back. You could do it with the offset here and move this around, but it's the control is not very intuitive, so I'm just going to set this back to zero. And then what I'm going to do is Shift A, add in a distort, you could add a translate node, you don't really need a transform for this one. And then we can just move this on the X. If you want to see what's happening, if we just isolate this by connecting this up to the viewer node, this is the original gradient, then we're translating it, moving it back to the more to the left so we get more of the white showing. So just keep moving this back until you find something that works for you. So this kind of looks good, but I want to get rid of this more and make this show up more. And a good way we can do that is Shift A, Converter Color Ramp. I'm going to just drop this after the Translate node. I want to just bring this down a bit to bring this to make this show more. Maybe that's too much. But I also want to bring this up a bit as well. You know, it's not too bad. If you can play around with it until you find something that works for you. Everyone's personal tastes are different. Some will like it, some won't. But I guess that looks fine. Now let's add the second gradient. Bring this over here. Shift A again. Color, mix. Drop this here. Shift A. Go to Input, Texture, and now let's select the other gradient that we created. And let's plug this color into this image slot here. And again, you can play around with the different blend modes. Soft light probably won't work for this one. It's maybe a bit too much, but you can drop it down. Yeah, it kind of looks okay, but I think if we go to overlay, it's a little better. I don't know. You could play around with it until you find something that works for you, but I think it ties it in a little bit more than, for example, if we didn't have it. This is before, this is after. Just ties it in a bit more. You can go ahead now and render this out. Change this from PNG to FFmpeg video. Select your encoding. We're going to choose presets, H.264 in MP4 format. This works for me. If you want to change these settings, play around with them, feel free to do that. Then we can go ahead and make sure you set your file output as well, so you know where this is saved to, and go ahead and hit animation. So it's a very quick way how to make a sci-fi sky. You can go ahead and build upon this, and if you make something cool, feel free to send us some links to our Facebook group. It's always great to see what you guys are making. But hopefully this tutorial helped. If it did, be sure to give it a like. And as always, thanks for watching.